Kelsey
and Kendra. And for today's First Time Friday, Kelsey and I are going to be doing a review and demo on the TRACEE ELLIS Ross Pattern hair care line. And when we first saw this on her Instagram that she was actually coming out with a hair care line for natural hair, I was super excited. Kelsey said she wasn't surprised. She said she expected it because her hair is her signature.
Yeah, she's been known for her hair for a while. When I used to watch Girlfriends, I used to be like, I love her hair. But of course, at the time, we were like, relaxed, and we weren't doing our own hair. Because we were watching Girlfriends we weren't supposed to be watching.
Yeah, we were really young. So,
yeah,
we were obsessed with it. Man, we still watch reruns now. And I love the name Pattern. It's just straight to the point. It's like clearly for natural hair. We're going to be reviewing everything that she has in the product line except for the leave-in conditioner, because when we were on the site, it was out of stock. And I was very disappointed because you guys know we're obsessed with leave-in conditioner.
Yeah.
I love leave-in conditioner. So,
So we're just going to do a part two with just using only the leave-in conditioner since it's out of stock right now, like Kendra just said. But when it restocks, I think she said it's going to restock on the 22nd and it's going to be available in Ulta. So we're probably going to go to the store first and see if we can pick up our own, and we're going to do one together like a live demo, like sitting right in front of the camera, because today we're doing cutaways as we talk through each product.
Yes, and it's more products, so that would have took a lot longer if we did it that way.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, so we have the shampoos, the conditioner, the heavy one, and two of her hair serums.
Yes.
So that's what we're gonna be reviewing today and showing demos of. So we're just gonna hop right into it and stop chit-chatting in the intro.
Okay, so the first product, of course, that we tried was the shampoo, and this is the Pattern Hydration Shampoo, and it gently cleanses and hydrates. And I already knew this was probably going to be a pearlized colored shampoo, because most shampoos that say hydrating are usually pearlized and not clear. Most clear shampoos are clarifying, and I prefer...
When she says pearlized, she means the look of it.
So yeah.
You might not know.
The color is pearlized.
Yeah, it's like a creamy, like pearl, like white
color. So I knew that it probably wasn't going to strip my hair, but I'm just going to go ahead and read what it says and let you guys know what I thought when I first rinsed it out of my hair. So it just says, a luxurious oil-boosted shampoo that gently lathers to cleanse hair and scalp, removing buildup without stripping away moisture. So I love when my shampoos lather, because some hydrating shampoos don't lather at all, really. And I kind of don't like that. I guess in my mind,
she likes the bubbles.
If it bubbles, it's cleansing in my mind. So I like a little lather. But a true test for me with the shampoo when I'm using it, like when I'm styling my hair curly, is if it strips my hair or not when I rinse it out. So I noticed when I was rinsing it out of my hair that my hair felt cleansed, but it didn't feel stripped. So,
and I actually used the shampoo before you did.
Yes.
And I told you when I rinsed it out, it felt clean,
but not stripped. So it does do what it claims to say on the back. So I did like that about it. We just decided to get the smaller sizes just because we don't use that much shampoo.
Yeah, we don't go through it fast at all.
Not at all. So this is the 3 fluid ounce, and this was $9. So
the shampoo comes in two sizes. So this is the 3 fluid ounce, and I think the second, the bigger size is a 9.8 fluid ounce, and that's $20. So the shampoo smells really light. It's a very understated smell.
Yeah.
So it's not a very potent, fragrant scent.
Just clean.
Just clean, simple, but like a warm clean. It's not like a sharp clean, if that makes sense, if you're curious about the smell.
Not a sharp clean.
Sharp mean like citrus or soapy.
Gotcha. I like those smells though.
I do too.
We're really into scents, but her products are very like understated. So that could be a good thing depending on if you like wearing perfume, you don't want your hair to overpower
but
your perfume.
But I wear perfume and I still love like a fragrant scented hair product.
Me too. Like when you like throw your hair and someone's behind you and they smell it.
Yeah.
Like,
but
I love that.
I'm glad she focused on the quality of like the actual benefits of the product.
Yes.
Because she did say it took years for her to come out with this line, so I'm sure she had a lot of samples, a lot of prototypes, and she wanted to get it right. So that's also why we trusted ordering the products online. Okay, so the second product that we got was the conditioner, and this is the largest size that it comes in. Kelsey thought it was smart to get the larger size because we were going to be sharing this.
Yeah, I knew we both were going to be using it, so I was like, I'm just going to order the big one. And I think the regular size was out of stock.
Yeah.
So I kind of didn't have a choice. The small one was out of stock, so I was like, we're just going to get the big one.
Yes. And it kind of worked out because we knew we both wanted to try it.
Yeah.
And this is the Pattern Heavy Conditioner for Coilies. It says, amplified hydration and nourishment. This is the 29 fluid ounce, so it's 29 fluid ounces. It comes in three different sizes, so it comes in a 3 fluid ounce, a 13 fluid ounce, and this one, which is the larger size. And I do love that she has three different types of conditioners. And if you guys are curly, you know that curly girls look for conditioner. This is what we run out of
the fastest.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So, it's a staple. Yeah.
And it's so like personal that mm-hmm. all conditioners aren't created equal. So like a heavy one might not work on someone with fine hair.
Yeah.
So mm-hmm. she does have three different ones. She has a medium one. She has a heavy one, which is this one. It's the middle one. And she has an intense one.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I love that she did that. And this one, I can't imagine how thick and intense the intensive one is.
Yes, because this one is already hella heavy. Thick.
Yes.
It's like very thick.
And it's like a deep conditioner.
Pretty much. Mm-hmm. And I did notice on the back that it did say, because it has like pro tip on the back of it. Mm-hmm. It just says for dry, brittle hair, leave conditioner on for 10 minutes as a repair treatment mask to help restore and revitalize your curls. Mm-hmm. So you can, if you're using this in the shower like I did, you can use it to detangle your hair and then leave it in for like 10 minutes and then shower and then rinse it out. Mm-hmm. So this is good for that as well. I used it for all three different things. I used it to condition my hair regular. I used it to deep condition. Okay. And I used it as a leave-in slash styler. So I used it for all three. So this is the only thing that I have in my hair currently. And my hair is super soft. It doesn't feel weighed down. It's not sticky. It's not greasy. So I just had to make it do what it do when I saw that the leave-in conditioner was out of stock.
Yeah.
So I was
trying to see if this worked in more than one way.
Yeah, so, and y'all know us, we always break the rules when it comes to conditioners. We've been using like rinse out conditioners as stylers since we started transitioning. Just because when we started transitioning, regular leave-ins didn't really work in our hair. They do work fine now, because we're all natural now. Mm-hmm. But I always like to go back to using a rinse out as a leave-in just because it gives so much definition, but still makes your hair super moisturized.
And this clumps the curls together really nicely. Yes. I also use this as a leave-in conditioner mm-hmm. only because I just wanted to see how this worked as just a leave-in, because I did use shampoo, of course, and I did a regular like deep conditioner and rinsed that out, and then I wanted to just strictly see how this worked as a leave-in. Kelsey used this, like as she said, in multiple ways.
Yeah. So I sectioned mine a little bit more. Uh-huh. You just used yours as a leave-in to like detangle and like maneuver through your hair.
I use this as a detangler. So this is so thick that if you don't want to, you don't have to go in inch by inch and do like tiny sections if you don't want to.
Which is
if
what
you're
I
using
did.
It as a leave-in.
Yeah.
So I just put my hair in like my normal four sections and I just kind of finger raked it through that whole section. Okay. And then I went back in with my Demon brush and I went in and detangled. So when you finger rake the product in, it's so thick and nourishing that it gets every strand, so it coats every strand. But I went back in with the Demon brush just to make sure that every strand got some love. So when I brushed through with the Demon brush, it felt super smooth, had a lot of slip. Like, it's a nice buttery conditioner.
Very buttery. Mm-hmm.
Super thick. When I tell y'all, this is extremely thick.
It's like cake frosting thick.
Yeah, it's like cake frosting. That's the mm-hmm. texture.
Yeah.
It has shea butter, avocado oil, and safflower oil in it. And it says it leaves hair luxurious and defined. So, I'm going to say that this was accurate.
It left my hair defined.
I loved it.
That's the only thing that's in my hair.
Again, the smell is very understated, like the shampoo.
Yeah. So I said none of them really have like a strong scent out of her product.
No. And I did put a gel on top of this. You guys know I'm a gel girl when it comes to my stylers. Like, I have to have a gel because my hair lasts longer. If not, then I got to do my hair like every 3 days and I don't feel like doing all that. So this works really well paired with a gel, if you're curious, because I'm a gel girl. And I'm curious to see what other stylers she's going to come out with. I think it was smart for her to initially come out with the wash day essentials, pretty much.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I thought that was wise.
The basics.
Yeah, the basics.
Yeah.
But I want to know if she's going to come out with a gel or not, because y'all know I love my gel. So.
But I feel like I love cream stylers, so I kind of knew that this would work really nicely as a styler for me. Mm-hmm. So if she did come out with a cream styler, I feel like it would be very similar to the heavy conditioner. Because this kind of feels like a... like a styling
curl cream. Defining cream.
Curl defining cream. So that's pretty much what this felt like when I was applying it while I was styling. Huh. So, and this is usually how my hair turns out when I use a cream styler too. So, yeah.
And if you guys are curious about the price of this size, it's $42. So, but this is a lot of conditioner. So,
So the last two products that we both got were two of her hair serums. I think these are the only two on the site currently. Mm-hmm. I got the jojoba oil hair serum and I got Kendra the argan oil hair serum. Mm-hmm. So we wanted to see the difference between the two or if they were like kind of similar. And the thing that I noticed about the jojoba oil compared to the argan oil is that the jojoba oil is very, very watery. It's like very lightweight. Mm-hmm. And I used it after I finished applying the conditioner. So I used it to style, to kind of like seal in the conditioner. And I also used it to kind of like scrunch out a little bit of crunch that I had, just a tad, not a whole lot. So this is a multi-use product. You guys know we use hair serums for a ton of different things. We use them when we first do our hair. We use them to maintain our hair throughout the week.
Mm-hmm. Add some shine, some hydration.
Yeah, so this just says this is a moisture boost for hair and scalp. So you can use this on your hair and your scalp if either one feels dry. It just says lightweight and residue free, our jojoba oil hair serum multitasks to provide extra hydration while also reviving the scalp when it needs a little love. Featuring a hearty blend of nourishing oils like jojoba and lavender. I knew I smelled lavender oil. Huh. I have not tried this on my scalp, but it does say it helps reduce scalp itchiness and flaking. So I'm pretty sure that's what the lavender oil is for, because I know lavender oil helps with like itching and like flaking of the scalp. Kind of like peppermint oil. Mm-hmm. They kind of work similar in a way. So I will try this on my scalp, but I only used it on my ends.
Mm-hmm. So. And the argan oil is a little bit on the thicker side. It's not a thick oil, but in comparison to the jojoba
oil. Yeah, it's thicker.
It's thicker. And when you rub it in, you can really feel the like thickness in the product. And I feel like it's a nice sealant. So it's going to lock in the moisture. So I noticed when I was kind of like finishing my hair, because I only used this at the very end when I was like scrunching my hair, like the cast from the styler that I put in. You know, the crunchy cast that some stylers leave in your hair. This did a really good job at just getting rid of that and adding some extra hydration and moisture to my hair. And I noticed that my hair felt sealed. Like, that's the first thing I noticed. It locked in the moisture and it kind of sealed in your style. So if you're looking for a thicker oil, something that's not super heavy, but if you don't want something as lightweight as the jojoba oil, the argan oil is a good option. They're both really nice. This, I would say, is more for like thicker textures, people with a lot of hair, if you have a problem with frizz, because argan oil is pretty well known for, you know, getting rid of frizz. So I highly recommend it. This one, however, does not have a scent to me. It kind of smells
lavender oil
unscented.
Because this one has lavender oil. That's what I smell.
This does not, and now I know why it feels thicker, because it does say that it has castor oil in it, which makes perfect sense, because if y'all know, castor oil
is super
probably
thick.
The thickest oil out there.
It's so thick.
In texture, and it's on the sticky side. This is not sticky, however. But now I know why it feels thicker than the jojoba oil. So I love that it has castor oil in it, though. That's good to know, because castor oil is A1 for your hair. It's very good for hair growth and strengthening the hair shaft.
Yeah.
Also, I did read that the shampoo contains biotin. So if you guys are curious about, you know, what other benefits the shampoo could do for you, it has biotin and it also has castor oil in it, so
which is great, both
great
for
things.
Strengthening and
hair growth.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, with the oils, what I'm noticing, to me, the jojoba oil, I like it for, like, obviously I use it on my ends. But since it has lavender oil in it, I'm going to try to use it for scalp massages, because my scalp does get kind of itchy sometimes. Mm-hmm. And then the argan oil seems great, like you said, to use as a sealant. Mm-hmm. To like seal in the moisture and lock in the moisture. Mm-hmm. So I like both of them. They were kind of pricey. They were $25. But most hair serums are not cheap.
No, they're not. And they last a long time, too.
Yeah, we have so many. I think that's why I thought it was kind of pricey, because I hadn't bought a hair serum in a while, because we have so many and they last such a long time, like you said, because we don't use a lot.
And also, if you guys are wondering, all these products are paraben free from what I've read. I think that's important if you're looking for that in your products, especially if you use the essentials a lot on a weekly basis, and if you're concerned about that. They're also color safe, so if you have like colored hair, that's good to know as well.
So yeah, that's pretty much it for this first part of the TRACEE ELLIS Ross Pattern Beauty hair products line. We're gonna do a part two, like I said, on the leave-in conditioner when we get our hands on it, since we didn't get a chance to. But if you guys wanna know more details about the products, we'll leave the site in the description box so you can kind of browse it yourself and see what you wanna try based on what we said. Yeah. So yeah, once again, we hope you guys enjoyed this video and we'll see y'all next time.